Good morning, students. So today I will be doing one poem for you. That is Benjamin Jones Goes Swimming. So it is written by Eileen Fisher. So this poem describes an incident in a very humorous manner. That is, in a very funny manner. It tells the story of Benjamin Jones, who participated in a swimming competition. So this poem is about a person named Benjamin Jones, and he had participated in a swimming competition. He was not a very good swimmer and he had not gone swimming for years. Still, he wanted to try and win. So this poem is about a competition. So all of us in our life, you know, one day or another, we take part in the competition. It may be any competition: drawing competition, essay competition, debate, or hairstyle competition, cooking without fire, or collage making. So many competitions are there. In our school we have many competition, is it not? And many of you students participate in these competitions, and your only one aim is to win. Yes, you prepare very well, and you wait for that day to arrive. You know, you will be very thrilled when the day of the competition is going to come. I should be prepared and I should win this competition. So we all of us feel that. So here also, this person, he too takes part in the swimming competition, and he too wants to win the competition. So let us begin with the poem. Benjamin Jones Goes Swimming. Benjamin Jones, in confident tones, told his wife, "On the 4th of July, I think I'll compete in the free for all meet. I bet I can win if I try." So Benjamin Jones, in very confident tones, he was very sure, he was too confident. He tells his wife that on the 4th of July, there is going to be a swimming competition, and it is free for all meet. It is a free competition. You don't have to pay anything in order to take part in that competition. No need to pay any money. It's free for all. In spite of your age also, it's open to all. This competition is open to all. So in a very confident tone, he tells his wife very confidently. He says, on the 4th of July, I think I am going to compete in this free for all meet competition. And he says, I bet I can win if I try. So he is very much sure. He says, I bet, I'll tell you, I'm really going to win this competition if I try. But his wife said, my word, how very absurd. But his wife said, you are so foolish, she says. You haven't gone swimming for years. With others so fast, you are sure to be last. And I blush to the tips of my ears. So she says, how very foolish. This is a very foolish decision you are making. You haven't gone swimming for years. She says, you have not practiced swimming and many years now you haven't gone for swimming. And others, with others so fast, you are sure to be last. She says, others who are other, compared to the other competitors, you will be the last one to reach the finishing line. And I blush to the tip of my, to the tips of my ears. Blush is to become red in the face. So she says, I blush to the tips of my ears. Well, the four quickly came and waiting acclaimed. But wonderful swimmers gallop. Gallop is in abundance or in plentiful. So the 4th of July quickly came, and it was the big day for Benjamin Jones. The competition day had come, and waiting acclaim were wonderful swimmers at gallop. Waiting acclaim means waiting for the praise. There were wonderful swimmers, very, you know, expert swimmers were there, who were, many expert swimmers were there in that competition. Each poised in his place for the start of the race. So each one was standing there, ready, poised for the race to begin. They were alert and they were ready while spectators crowded the shore. So on the shore there were many spectators. They were watching this competition. The contest began and Benji poor man was passed on the left and the right. So the contest began and poor Benjamin, he was passed on the left and the right by the other swimmers. From the left side, you know, somebody would pass and go ahead. From the right side, somebody would pass and go ahead. And he was left behind. His pace was so slow that the crab saw his toe and thought he would venture a bite. The speed, his pace of swimming was so slow that a crab which was there in the water saw Benjamin's toe, and the crab also thought that it would try to venture a bite, the crab also tried to bite Benjamin's toe. Ben noticed the crab as it started to grab, and perhaps the result can be guessed. So Benjamin noticed the crab, you know, coming towards his toe, and he noticed the crab trying to grab his toe, and perhaps the result can be guessed. So now you can guess what next will happen. After seeing the crab coming towards his toe, Benjamin was very much frightened. The only thing he could do to escape from this clutches of the crab was to swim fast. And thought of his toe in the claws of his foe made him swim like a swimmer possessed. So the very thought of his toe in the claws of that crab, claws of his foe. Your foe is enemy. The enemy of Benjamin Jones here is the crab. The very thought of his toe in the claws of his foe. What is claws? Sharp nails of an animal or bird's foot. You know that crab, they have that claws, and you know it hurts very badly. If they catch you with their claws, it hurts very badly. So the very thought of his toe in the claws of his foe, that is the enemy, the crab, made him swim like a swimmer possessed. Possessed means here, like a swimmer possessed means a swimmer who is controlled by extraordinary spirit possessed. So he started swimming like a swimmer possessed. He got that energy, he got that strength, you know, out of fright. He started swimming very fast. As Ben took the lead in the dash, and he took the lead in the dash, he went ahead of all the swimmers. While his wife on the dock received such a shock, she fell in the lake with a splash. So while his wife was standing on the dock, the area on the port which is used for, you know, loading and unloading the goods. So when the wife was standing on the dock and she received such a shock seeing her husband, you know, swimming like an expert swimmer, she never believed, because he had not gone swimming for years. He did not have a very good practice. Unless and until you have good practice, you cannot win. Hard work is very important. Now suppose you want to take part in your annual sports. So all of you will go for volleyball practice is there, throwball practice, yes. Some say I want hurdles practice is there, chess practice is there. Before that event, you want to have some practice. So she was so shocked after seeing her husband swimming like an expert swimmer, and he had won the competition. She was so shocked that she fell in the lake with a splash. So here we can see that it is the confidence, or you can say is willpower, which made Benjamin Jones to swim like an expert swimmer. Of course he was he was trying to escape from that crab, but still he had that willpower, because he had already said, if I try, I bet I can win this competition. So he had extraordinary willpower to win this competition, and he was successful. He succeeded in winning this swimming competition. So here, where there is a will, there is a way. Your willpower, your firm determination only can take you to the road of success. So this is the poem, children, written by Eileen. fisher. I will just forward these meanings in the group and also the question answers, and do your work very neatly. I am very happy that all of you are doing your homework and forwarding your assignments. So keep it up, children, and do well.